نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله جل وعلا من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ثم أما بعد Brothers and sisters, how important for you as a Muslim to have good manners? That's a question I would like every one of you to ask himself this question. يعني when you realize, when you're going to know, Prophet ﷺ said in the authentic hadith from Abu Hurairah, إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ I just came. I just been sent. إِنَّمَا بُعِثْتُ لِأُتَمِّمَ مَكَارِمَ الْأَخْلَاقِ I came to make the good manners complete. I came to teach my followers, and teach the whole world, and teach the whole humanity, how important to have the good manners. The message of the Prophet ﷺ to you is to have the good manners. And that's why we had a great alim, his name was Ibn al-Qayyim. Ibn al-Qayyim was saying that the religion is about manners. Whoever has higher and better manners than you, he's much more religious than you. The religion is about manners. If someone has better manners than you, he's much more religious than you. So it's very important to ask yourself, do you have good manners or not? يعني when you know the Prophet ﷺ said in the hadith, hadith كما عن أبي الدرداء in Sunan al-Tirmidhi. Prophet ﷺ said, once we die, when we die, we're going to go to Allah Azza wa Jal. طيب, Allah Azza wa Jal, in the day of judgment, you're going to have a sky. The sky will have two sides. Okay? The good deeds in the side and the bad deeds in the other side. Prophet ﷺ said, the most heavy part, please concentrate, the most heavy part in your good deeds will be the good manners. How you deal with others. How you talk. Prophet ﷺ said in the same hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ Allah Azza wa Jal doesn't like. الفاحش البذيء. This bad words comes out of your mouth. You have to control it. The good thing, in the manners is you can change it. We have something called الخلق, how you look outside, and something called الخلق, the inside part. The inside part, the good point is you can change it. You can try to control yourself. So when you talk, how you talk? How are you dealing with the backbiting? يعني if you are two people sitting together, or three people sitting together, and one left the meeting. So, what we gonna talk about after he left? How he was talking? How he was sitting? How he looks like? That's backbiting. And Allah Azza wa Jalla said, I would like you to imagine, Allah Azza wa Jalla is the most merciful. You as a Muslim, has to believe deeply that Allah Azza wa Jalla created you to go to Jannah. If you don't believe in that, you're not a true Muslim. Allah created you to go to Jannah. Imagine the most merciful is starting a verse in the Quran in Surah Al-Humma, they say, Wail, it's a valley in the hellfire, may Allah protect us. So he said, Wailun li kulli, the hellfire forever. Wailun li kulli humazatil lumaz. Humazatil lumaz? They say, Humazatil lumaz is the one who backbites. The one who put the people down. He's going to go to the hellfire. So how is it done? This is very important question. Another thing. How are you doing your work? Now, whatever the work, whether you're a teacher, or a doctor, or engineer, or a security guard, or cleaner, how are you doing your work? Because if you're going to fear Allah Azza wa Jal in your work, you're going to pass. There is another surah in Juz' Amma, and actually start with the word way. Again, the most merciful is starting a surah with the word way. What's way? It's a valley in the hellfire again. And how dangerous is the issue? وَيْلٌ لِلْمُطَفِّفِينَ Who are the mutaffifin? Al-mutaffifin, someone giving less measure of weight. Whatever you are doing, you're supposed to do a specific job in a specific time in a specific way. If you give less, why? According to the verse. And that's why very important, when you do your job, you have to do it in the right way. Otherwise, you're going to go to the punishment. And that's why there is something very important, wallahi. Please concentrate. As Muslims, we're not allowed to live in non-Muslim country unless we have a message. And the message is to spread Allah's word around. We're not going to push anyone to do it. We're not going to push anyone to follow it. We're just spreading it. And the best way ever to spread it by action. And the people will never, listen to that carefully, the people will never be attracted to your religion through your worshipping actions. Never. How many times you praying a day? 5 times a day and we'll pray Sunday. Oh, that's very complicated. And you fast Ramadan, you stop eating, it's very complicated. But if you're going to do your job, in front of a Muslim or non-Muslim, Wallahi al-Azim, you're feeling and you're hearing and you're finding very sad stories and experience. Akhi, I'm buying a car. Okay. The one who sells the car, his name is Ahmed. No, no, refrain, go away. Why? Because his name is Ahmed. And that's why now they write their names Mu, and you call him in Lebanese at the end of the day. Or Michael. Akhi, what's your name? My name is Muhammad. What's Michael? I have to write Michael, otherwise no one's going to check my car. So we are dealing with each other, we cannot afford it. And you think they will listen to our religion? They will respect us? Wallahi ladhi la ilaha ghayruh. If we are, you can feel it's not important, but it's important because you're going to be asked in their judgment. Me and you, we're going to go to the graveyard. And they live after. And they go back. And you're going to deal with Allah Azza wa Jal. And the most important question, what did you do with my religion? Allah Azza wa Jal chose you. Allah Azza wa Jal chose you to leave your country and come here. You didn't hear, you didn't come here because you are clever. No, Allah chose you. You are Allah's choice to be here. What did you do with this amana which He gave you? You think you came to Australia just to have fancy life? No, you have a message. So if you're going to do your job in the right way, most of the Muslims, if the Muslims are going to do your job in the right way, wallahi, people will enter the Islam in afwaj and groups. And again, we don't push anyone to do it. Do you know what's our problems, brothers? Please concentrate. Our problem, we are as Muslim. When I say as Muslim, always remember, it's never been an aim or a goal to put you down. It's just something make the person sad and we talking together about it. We are as Muslims. When I say as Muslims, I meant born as Muslims. Born as Muslims. We are as Muslims. Our problem with our religion, Islam, is not we're not practicing, no. Our problem with our religion, Islam, is we do not understand it. Wallahi, we don't. Seriously, we don't. Yani, if we're going to go to the fiqh books, you have to read sometimes the fiqh books. All the fiqh books, you will never ever, I'm just going to give you an example, you will never ever find any section or any bab or any place in the fiqh books talking about the hijab, the scarf. Never ever. No, in the fiqh books, a section of the knowledge talking about the scarf. Never. No. What they're talking about? They're talking about the private part. They're talking about the awrah. Okay. So al-hijab has to cover the awrah. So if a lady covering her head and her body showing, especially the size, she defeated the purpose. At the end of the day, alhamdulillah, she is covered. Why? Because her head is actually covered. But no, that's not the point. The point is she has to be covered, not her head. So we don't really understand. I would like to ask a question. Ask yourself. I'm asking myself too. Again, don't think we are wallahi together. Sometimes you are much better. Now, I'm going to ask a question. If we are in the masjid now, we have some brothers, unfortunately, they love talking before the Salat al-Jum'ah. You have a lot of ahadith at the chat, mashallah, good conversation. And we said, Ya Akhi, remember Allah Azza wa Jal. Ya Akhi, read some Quran. Ya Akhi, you are in a time which is very important. Allah Azza wa Jal chooses to come early. Now they're talking. You came to pray sunnah here. Will you concentrate the Salah? No. Most likely, if you understand the language they're talking about, you're going to know the whole conversation and the whole story. If you are in a room, and two people or two kids talking about something and you are praying, it will be never. Or very difficult to concentrate. But why? When I read something on WhatsApp or Facebook, and my wife talking to me, I never listen to her and I don't really know what she said. If I'm in WhatsApp or Facebook, the wife talking, and this is one of the big problems with us and husband. He is always with his phone. So if she's talking to me while I'm reading something on Facebook, I never concentrate. But while I was praying, I knew the whole conversation. Why? What is the reason? Because I don't understand what the Salah. Salah is you talking to Allah Azza wa Jal. Salah, you have to be connected to Him. Salah, that you have, that's something you have to enjoy it. I was enjoying the Facebook, and that's why I didn't concentrate with my wife. But the Salah, I would like to finish it. I would like to finish it. And that's why you have the question, in Ramadan especially, which masjid praying the biggest number of raka'at and finishing early? Allahu Akbar. Is that the point? You pray two raka'at only, but pray properly. Pray to use whom, akhi. So our problem with Islam, please understand. Yeah, it's a big part. It's a big part to try to understand what's the problem. We're talking about the good manners now. You have to know your manners. What are your problems? I'm not a patient person. I don't have patience. I don't have sabr. I'm just giving an example. I don't have sabr. Imagine. Allah Azza wa Jalla, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah Azza wa Jalla in the Quran said something very important. What did He say? He said, إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ إِنَّمَا يُوَفَّى الصَّابِرُونَ أَجْرَهُمْ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. In the day of judgment, people who have patience, They can have the reward without calculation. Why, Ya Allah? Why? The ulama say, because sabr, patience is ibad. Okay, salah is ibad. Fasting is ibad. Al-hajj is ibad. No. Al-sabr is painful ibad. Painful ibad, painful. And that's why the reward, no calculation with it. So I don't have patience, and that happened to all of us. So I have to work for it. Why? Listen to me carefully. Why, if I have any physical, if I have any physical problem, Allahu Akbar, I go to the best specialist. It doesn't matter, the money may stop. And they search about this specialist. But when it comes to the religion, I'm asking the first person in front of me whether he's a sheikh or not. Whether he has knowledge or not. And they didn't ask about the qualification. I'm telling you, it's something very permissible to ask about the qualification of the person before you ask him any question in the religion. Ask him, who are you? Are you qualified in this? What's the problem with it? When it comes to body, I do my best to have the best specialist. Even this body is going to be dust very soon. But my religion is much more important. So I have to find out what are my problems. I tell you something, you might find it very strange, but let me tell you. If you like really to know what are your problems, ask your wife. You're going to think now he's a big... No, ask your wife. Ask your wife. What are my problems? Ask you to write it, not to say it. I'm working for it. Wallahi, I'm serious. Work for it. You're not patient enough, okay? You are easy to be angry. You're screaming all the time. Okay, if you're gonna have this and work on it, you'll be a successful person. What are your points of the life? You came to the life to be happy, isn't it? And you have to be happy in the day of judgment. Work on it. So our problem as Muslims generally wouldn't understand our religion. The hijab is a part. Imagine, wallahi, I would like you to imagine. Imagine a nation. They cannot understand their book. They cannot understand what Allah Azza wa Jal sent. Yeah, Allah Azza wa Jal sending you a message to apply it. And you read it and you don't understand what's in it. One of the brothers was talking to me. He's working in a big company, IT company. A non-Muslim person was calling him. They're working together. So he found the Quran on his table. So he told him, is that your book? Al Quran? The guy said, yes. He said, is it a different language? He said, yes, Arabic language. He was very proud. Wow, do you know how to read it? Our friend said, yes, definitely. He said, can you please read it? He read one verse. He said, wow, what is the meaning? What is the meaning of what you read? He said, no, I don't know. He said, no. What you see now, what the God would like to say? No, he doesn't know. He does not know. Imagine you reading a message from someone sent to you and you don't know what you are reading. It's a disaster. Do you think we really understand our religion? And we keep blaming. Why the Muslims deal with each other in a very bad way? Why? Why the Muslims, they hate to deal with each other? Why? Why the divorce is very high between the Muslim families? Why? Why some of our kids, they live in the religion? Why? Do I really understand what I'm saying? Do I really understand what Allah Azza wa Jalla would like me to do? Do I really understand which good manners should I have? The best and the most important good manners ever I have to have with Allah Azza wa Jalla. How to have a good manners with Allah Azza wa Jalla? A question. How to have good manners with Allah Azza wa Jalla? First thing, a shuk. Concentrate, a shuk. The first word ever in the Quran is Alhamdulillah. Thank Allah Azza wa Jalla with what Allah Azza wa Jalla gave you. Do not ever or do not always think about what you missed. You have a lot of good stuff, isn't it? And that's why Alhamdulillah, the first word, Allah Azza wa Jalla said in Surah Al-Adiyat. Surah Al-Adiyat. Inna al-insana li rabbihi lakanud. All the mankind, most likely we have an insan Arabic language in the Quran with alif wa lam, non-Muslim insan, not good insan. Inna al-insana li rabbihi lakanud, and the mankind are ungrateful to Allah Azza wa Jalla. He always thinks about the thing he missed. The thing he missed, not the thing he has. We are in a big ni'am, but we don't feel it. Yesterday, I was talking to one of the sisters. She's telling me about a problem with another sister in Australia. This sister, 34 years old. She has blood cancer in the fourth stage. And she's gonna die soon. But that's not the problem. The problem is, she has two kids. One is 15 years old, a boy, and the other one is 13 years old, a girl. It's not the problem. The problem is their father left them long time ago and they don't know where he is. When the mother died, what will happen to the kids? Alhamdulillah, you don't have this problem. You have said alhamdulillah for your heart. That's a big ni'mah you have. So, al-adab ma Allah Azza wa Jal, the good manners with Allah Azza wa Jal, you have to thank Allah Azza wa Jal. Number two, to repent to Allah Azza wa Jal all the time. Allah Azza wa Jal yuhibbu tawwabina. He loves you to repent all the time. Repent is not because you've done a bad deed, repent is because you've done shortage in your ibad. You think you want to pray, you really pray in the right way? Or in the way which Prophet was doing? Or in the way which supposed to be? Or the way which is suiting or matching with Allah Azza wa Jal? No. So repent to Allah Azza wa Jal. The most important good manners has been through Allah Azza wa Jal or towards Allah Azza wa Jal. Second one, your family. Your family. Yani it is a disaster. Wallahi disaster. If we find some of the brothers, they are the most clever people talking to others outside. He has a way of talking, brother, mashallah. You enjoy listening to him. How he talks to his parents, to his wife and his kids and his parents. Prophet said in the hadith, خيركم, the best one of you. خيركم لأهله. The best one of you, the one who is good to his family. وأنا خيركم لأهلي. والله الذي لا إله غيره. You are the most successful person. If when we ask your wife about you, she praising you. She said, alhamdulillah, he's a good person. Alhamdulillah, he fears Allah Azza wa Jalla. Alhamdulillah, he's dealing with me in a good way. That's a good, you succeeded. You succeeded. But if we're asking your wife about you and she's not saying that, that's a problem. You are a big fail. Even if you are very successful outside. And I would like to say, tell me a point here. Tell me a point. You teach, pass it, tell it to your wife. And if some sisters listening, never ever, you as a man, criticize the mother in front of your daughters. Don't do that. Even if your wife, you don't like what she's doing, don't criticize in front of the girls. Don't do that. The mother for the girls is the hero of them. So you're going to put her down, you're putting your kids down, and they're going to be in really, really in a big trouble. And ask your wife not to criticize you in front of the boys and the girls too. Yeah, do not criticize each other in front of each other at the home. Don't do that. And that's why, what Allah Azza wa Jalla said in the Quran? Concentrate, concentrate, concentrate. Look, وَالَّتِي تَخَافُونَ نُشُوزَهُنَّ. Solving the problem in the Quran between the wife and husband, not to wait till the problem happens. No, 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 no. You think the problem will happen. Start. Start. Huh? What's the problem? And look at the Quran. فَعِذُهُنَّ. Huh? And then, look. وَحْجُرُهُنَّ فِي الْمَضَاجَ. Look. If there is a problem between you and your wife, fix the problem in the bedroom. In the bedroom. Not outside. Because of the kids. Our kids in a big risk. So I would like to be practical. I'd like to be practical. Try to find out what's your bad manners. What are your bad manners? What are your good manners? The bad manners, ask for it. Definitely, you know what are your problems. If you feel that you are arrogant, work on it. Search. Ask. Because the Prophet said, I've seen a very scary hadith. What did he say? He said, the one who has an atom of arrogance, will never enter the paradise. Allahu Akbar. That's very, very scary. The one who has an atom of arrogance will never have the smell of the paradise. What's arrogance? When I see myself better than everyone else, it's a very bad sign. It's a very bad sign. If you think, you know, I'm the best in your career, okay, in your personality, in your looking, in your rank, in your money, in your house, in your car, that's arrogance. That's arrogance. Work for it. Try to fix it. Try to feel Allah Azza wa Jal. We're going to go to Him very soon. And when we go to Allah Azza wa Jal, He's going to ask us. So try to be practical. Find out if you like to. Wallahi, let me conclude with this. When we were studying Islamic studies in university, they taught us something very important. They told us, if you'd like to be big da'iyah, you like to be big da'iyah, it's not just me, all of you. If you like to be big da'iyah without reading a lot of books, without reading big books, have good manners. You'll be a big da'iyah. Deal with others in good manners. You'll be the big da'i. Better than reading a lot of books. Why? Because the people, tarbiyah boy, because the people learning by their eyes more than they're learning by the ears. Talk about the sadq, 100 hours. And lie in front of the kids. You are a liar. And they are very smart. They will catch it. They will catch it. You talk with someone on the phone. Brother, sorry, I was sleeping, I just woke up. And you were not sleeping. The kids saw you. Brother, sorry, I'm outside now. Once I go back home, I'll talk to you. Allahu Akbar. And you think me telling your kids in the class, trustful or being trustworthy person is important, who listen, it's very difficult. So be a practical person. And every Friday, there is an hour, if you make the Allah, inshallah, Allah will listen to us, say amen from your heart. Allahumma rabbana salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad fil awwalin. Allahumma rabbana salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad fil akhirin. Allahumma rabbana salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad fi kulli waqtin wahin. I'm going to make dua for the Muslims who are struggling around the world. اللهم انصر الاسلام واعز المسلمين اللهم انصر المسلمين في كشمير رب العالمين وفي غزه وفي كل مكان يستضعف فيه من يقول لا اله الا الله اللهم رد المسلمين الى دينك ردا جميلا I'm also gonna make dua for the Muslim kids, the young generation who are really need hidayah. Say amen from your heart. اللهم اهدي ابناء وبنات المسلمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعل ابناء وبنات المسلمين بارين بابائهم وامهاتهم يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزق ابناءنا وبناتنا فهما لكتابك الحكيم يا رب العالمين. واخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وجزاكم الله خيرا. وعليكم السلام.